Hey guys, welcome to our channel Logic to Code. So in this video I'll be solving the question best time to buy and sell stock 2. So I'll give this link in the description section so you may have a look at it. So let me read the problem statement. So say you have an array for which the ith element is the price of a given stock on day I. So design an algorithm to find the maximum profit. You may complete as many transactions as you like. So you may not engage in multiple transactions at the same time. You must sell the stock before you buy again. So what it says is that, so let's say you have given an array of numbers in which each number represents the price of the stock on a particular day. So in this array, 7 represents the price of stock on day 1, similarly 1 on day 2, 5 on day 3, 3 on day 4, 6 on day 5, and 4 on day 6. And what you have to tell is that, so it is given that you can do as many transactions as you want. So what do I mean by transactions? So one transaction is equivalent to buying a stock and then selling the stock. But the constraint is that first you buy the stock and then sell the stock. So you cannot sell a stock before buying that, right? So you can buy and sell, you can do as many transactions as you can, and you need to tell that what is the maximum profit that you can make out of it, right? So in this question, the maximum profit is 7, and how it comes is that, so you buy the stock on day 2, so you'll invest 1 rupees and then sell on this stock on day 3, so we'll get 5 rupees out of it, so your profit will be 4. And then you'll buy on day 4 at rupees 3 and then sell on day 5 at rupees 6. So the profit from here you'll get 3 and the profit from here will get 4. So total profit will be 7, right? So this is the explanation of this test case. Similarly, you can do for this. So here the profit would be you buy on 1, day on sell on day 2. Buy on day 2, sell on day 3, buy on day 2, 3 and sell on day 4, and buy on day 4 and sell on day 5. So the profit would be like what, 4. Or the other option could be like you buy on day 1 and sell on day 5. In that case also you get a profit of 4, right? So this is the like crucial test case to understand what is the what would be the logic for this particular question. So now let me explain what could be the logic to solve this particular problem. So I have already explained this test case, so let me write the test case, second test case. So 1 2 3 4 5, right? So in this test case, what you think, like how you can, when, at which day you will buy the stock and at which day you will sell the stock? So as for the explanation of this test case, so he's buying the stock on day 1 and selling the stock on day 5. So the profit is what? Profit is what? 5 minus 1, which is equals to 4, right? But what I have told you is that buy on day 1, sell on day 2, buy on day 2 and then sell on day 3, buy on day 3 and then sell on 4, and then again buy on 4 and sell on 5. So what would be the profit in that case? Profit is equals to what? 2 minus 1 plus 3 minus 2 plus 4 minus 3 and then what, 5 minus 4, right? So in that case only also you will get the profit as 4, right? So this is the, if you carefully observe this thing, the problem is like solved. So what I'm saying is that, so you may think that you don't want to sell the stock, you just wait for a day which gives you the maximum profit, right? So that's what, as per the explanation, he bought the stock on day 1 and sell on the day 5. Why? Because he think that this will give him the maximum profit. But what I'm saying is that you don't wait for getting the maximum profit. As long as you are getting some profit, just sell that stock and buy on that particular day also. So in that case also you get the profit same as the maximum profit. So why it's giving that? So this is a quick proof of that. Let's say XYZ is the price of stock, which is, and in that case let's say Z greater than Y greater than X. So according to this explanation, the profit would be what, Z minus X, but according to me the profit would be Y. Profit would be what, Y minus X plus Z minus Y, which essentially gives you Z minus X, right? So as I have already told you that even if you sell immediately, you are not going to get less profit, right? So only the approach would be purely greedy. You don't have to wait. Even if you get something, just sell the stock and get small amount of profit and just accumulate this small profit, and you are not going to get ever the less profit than the global profit, right? So the logic is pretty simple. So if AI plus 1 greater than AI, you make a profit of this and just add this profit to your global profit, and you are done with that. So now let's see the code for this. So I have initialized the profit equals to 0, and I am going to like all the prices dot size. So this is the prices dot size, and if prices of 5 minus prices 5 minus 1 greater than 0, which means I can buy the stock on this day I minus 1 and sell this stock on day I, right? And in that, if I do that, I'll make a profit of this prices of 5 minus prices of 5 minus 1. So I just add this profit to my global profit and add the end return this profit. So that's it. So I hope you understood the logic and the code as well. So let me run this code. Now let me submit this. So that's it. So I hope you like this video. So if you like our content, don't forget to subscribe this channel. So that's it for this video. Have a nice day.